And to make, the reason why the Americans are really fighting this, I mean, you want to get paid when your stuff's on radio, right? They're really fighting it because overseas, they're not paying our artists because we're not paying their artists. So it's a double whammy, or a quadruple, whatever that whammy, where the other countries aren't paying the American artists either. Okay, or the company. But by doing sound exchange, and it's what's really funny and good to a point, I run into a couple of clients, they never knew about sound exchange, doing sound exchange, and they made like $10,000 or $12,000. The sound exchange had no idea who to pay because they had enough stuff on YouTube and stuff like that. All of a sudden they got a nice check. So if your name's been up on YouTube and all that, satellite radio and everything else, now you have to have signed a recorded contract. There's reasons to my madness. You need that recorded contract to your record company because you have to, it's 50% to the record company, 50% to the artist. Okay? Now, what a lot of people get mixed up on, and this is part of step two, after you join Sound Exchange and as a label and artist, and also for the registered the songs you're going to release, a lot of people mix up the Copyright Bureau and ASCAP and BMI. Because they hear the term registered. Okay? Now, it's easy to remember. Because I've been asked to speak on this, I didn't know it was so prevalent, but what the Copyright Bureau is doing, first of all, one thing you have to understand about a copyright, as the Copyright Office says, as soon as it's affixed to something tangible, it's copyrighted. Which means you can see it or hear it, it's copyrighted. You don't have to go to Washington for it to have copyright. You right away can use the circle with the C. This is called the copyright notice, and it's got to be done exactly this way, in order. But say it's a song, and I wrote a song, let's say. So it's circle with the C, and the year, 2016 in this case, and let's say my company owned it, so it's Pooch. Okay? And by the way, for the recording, it's circle with the P, 2016, and I'm just going to abbreviate such a photograph. Okay? You can use that right away. But if it goes to court and you're sued, you better have that registration number in Washington. One of my artists just wrote a thing, and once you have a hit with a major artist, everybody comes out of the woodwork and starts suing you. But we had a copyright registration date that they couldn't get around. Okay? So the copyrights is part of the step two. But see, we didn't do copyrights before till we got to step two because your name's not going to be on the copyright except as the creative person. Let's go back to the song again. Okay? Back to the song copyright, circle with a C. It's performing arts. Let's say you're a songwriter. What'll happen is you'll check for music and lyrics or whatever you fit into this. It's a checklist. It's so online now. It's easy. And it remembers what you did. So you don't have to start over each time, which is great. Believe me, I love that. Okay? But the most important part of a copyright, you're going to see the term copyright claimant. And I think I used up this thing earlier. Copyright claimant. That means the owner. So when it gets to copyright claimant, you don't want to use your name. You want to use your publishing company name. Who's going to own your recording when you do that? The sound recording? Your record company's going to own it. But you had to put everything in step one together to do step two, because one of the things you did when you got that tax number for the LLC is when you signed up as a songwriter, you used your social security number with ASCAP or BMI, but the publisher used your tax number.